Hi, in this video I'm going to go through the setup and use of the Andeman BC-301 battery charger. Alright, so this is intended to replace my trusty K-Mart KM-100 battery charger from, I don't know, maybe the early 70s. Let's see how this compares. To begin with, the dimensions are 8.5 inches tall, 10.5 inches deep, and 6 inches wide. It weighs about 10 pounds. The cables are about 1 meter or 3 feet long. The back of the unit houses a 30 amp 250 volt fuse. As a reminder, chargers like this are not for lithium ion batteries, only for 12 or 24 volt lead acid batteries like from your car or riding lawnmower and such. Inside the unit is a nice big heavy step down transformer, a rectifier, and overall looks pretty well made with good solder joints. Let's get this zipped back up. Alright, so here I'm charging an old aircraft battery. This battery is used in the garage for sharpening chainsaw blades. So when we first connect the battery charger, it automatically detects that it is a 12 volt battery and it's showing us that it's at 75% charge, which seems about right based on how much this battery has been used since the last charge. I've got the charger set to smart, auto off, and all weather, and I'll switch it to fast charge. So the charger is now energized and shows it's charging at about 23 amps, 13.8 volts, and is about 50% done charging the remaining 25% of the battery. I've sped up the footage here. The battery quickly settles in to about 20 amps and 14.4 volts, and 70% charging or so. Now if I turn the charger off in order to monitor the charge, we see that it's showing 100% charged and about 12.6 volts. I'm going to turn it back on to fast charge. Since the auto off is selected, it will automatically turn off once it's fully charged. Okay, so I also wanted to test the repair feature of the battery charger. Honestly, I didn't hold out much hope here because this lawnmower battery is about 10 years old and totally shot. Spoiler alert, I was not able to bring this battery back to life. However, going through the process is a useful exercise. So, connecting the battery, we immediately see that it's at 15% and 10.8 volts. Not promising at all. First of all, let's just set this to the same settings as previously. Smart, auto off, and all weather, and see what happens. We can see that it reads 95% charged and 6.8 amps, and the voltage is 15.7 volts. Very strange values. Disconnecting it temporarily, it shows 100%. So let's set it to the repair setting. Now the current increases to 10 amps, and the repair light starts to blink. I've sped up the video here, and the amperage increases to 20.3 amps after 20 minutes of repair. And here we're at 2 hours later and still at 95%. Turning it off shows 100% charged and 13 volts. So, as I mentioned, I was not able to repair this battery to an operable state just by using the repair feature, but I suspect it was a lost cause from the beginning, so I'm not blaming the charger itself. Alright, this can also be used as a trickle charger by setting it to maintain, and it also has a winter setting for very cold operation. And that's about it. I hope this was useful. Talk to you next time. All the best.